My sorrow also you knew full well, nor was my frame unknown to you when I was made in secret, when I was fashioned in the depths of the earth. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Paul said, God raised up David as king. Of him God testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish. From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, has brought to Israel a Savior, Jesus. John heralded his coming by proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, what do you suppose that I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet. My brothers, sons of the family of Abraham, and those of us among you who are God-fearing, to us this word of salvation has been sent. The word of the Lord. Obviously a negative way of thinking, so much more important
times about all the blessings that God has shown us throughout our lives and the people who have blessed us in special ways. And to thank God for all those people and events. Looking forward, the idea that this feast brings home to us, well, John the Baptist had a special vocation, but each one of us has a vocation from God in these time and circumstances that we have. We can pray and ask God to guide us to do exactly what he wants us to do, to be of service to God and to our neighbor.
Say the apostles. Blessed are you, Lord God, for all creation, for the old and the seed for every all people. Fruit of the earth and birth of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be to God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, for all creation, for you have commissioned the seed of the wine you offer, fruit of the vine and of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be to God forever.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and my all. We place these offerings on your altar, Lord, to celebrate the fitting honor of the Timothy family, who both foretold the coming of the world's Savior and pointed him out in the kingdom, and lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We have no control of
the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just that we give our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, we follow the mighty name of God through Christ our Lord. It is precursorously done to manage. We praise your great glory, for you consecrate him for a singular honor of the most born women. His birth brought great rejoicing, even in the womb he left for joy, at the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the land of redemption. To make holy the flowing waters, he baptized every water with baptism, and was privileged to bear his supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. And so in the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth and before your majesty, without end and your time.
Holy, 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 holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them to do for you, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time when he was betrayed and committed into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, the chapel of St. Peter took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection, and say you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped others worthy to be in your presence as it is good to you. Humbly pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb. having feasted at the banquet of heaven and failed, and finding joy in the nativity of St. John the Baptist, your church we know as the overflow of your word, the Christ who is coming down to our soul, lives in my ancient heaven.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So much of it.